again. It's your boy Young Guilt the Foo Foo.
And your girl B Polly on the track.
Yeah, man. And y'all tuned in to
Gramlife.
And look, man, on this episode, man, we might just give y'all some weekly recaps of what's been going on the past week and turn ups and all kind of stuff like that. It's been a lot of stuff, man. And today's been a lot of random stuff going on.
So, you know, it's October. Waptober.
Waptober. Hey, man, shout out to East Atlanta, shout out to West Atlanta, shout out to Atlanta in general. You know what I'm saying?
Well, my stuff love Atlanta.
Yeah, but look, man, it's been a lot of random shit going on today, bro. So,
for no apparent, maybe it's the weather. Look at the sky.
I think it's, yeah, look at the sky. So y'all gonna see all that in this episode. So yeah, man, let's just get right into it, man.
Stay tuned.
Stay tuned. This is Gramlife.
The movement.
Hey, 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 hey. We at GS. Hey, hey. I thought you knew. We at GS. Woo! I thought you knew.
Oh, it's Gramlife, baby. We here.
This is Gramlife.
Gramlife, what's up?
Gramlife.
Hey, this is Gramlife.
What up, y'all? This is G-R-A-M, Gramlife.
This is Gramlife.
This is Gramlife. First event I think we should start with, Bree, is the Poise fashion show, Pink Poison. You know what I'm saying?
You know what, Gil? I did not realize how much talent we had on this campus. Like, mostly all of those items were handmade by students.
Yes, man. That's the black excellence in that show was just cray-ray. You know what I'm saying? So the first clip we're going to cut to, we're going to show y'all some of the models and them ripping the runway. We had some fine girls out there,
and
man.
Don't forget about the males, because, honey, when I tell you we had some sexual chocolates in the building.
Ugh, girl, go on. Let's just see it, man. Models was fine, boy. Man, I wish I could watch that thing again. But look, man.
That crowd was not messing with us.
Yes, bro. They was not, bro. I'm talking about at first, like, I was like, dang, I don't know if they just got done taking some midterms or they still had to study
or
them
something.
For...
That wasn't the Grams, fam.
Man.
I knew.
Yeah,
you
that
wasn't
the Grams, I knew, bro. I wasn't messing with it. At first, I was like, man, I just want to pack up and quit, man. But you got to persevere. You know what I'm saying?
Let me tell you how we got the crowd hyped, though. One dude, all white, I'm talking about, looked like Yo Gotti or something, came up to the front. I'm talking about live. I'm like, well, dang, he should have started the show.
Oh, he's my boy Pedro.
Yeah.
Man, hey, Pedro had them bars. Everybody know who Pedro is. Pedro, little short dude running here that be rapping. Hey, bro, got them bars for days, bro. He came and turned the crowd up, man. After that, it was smooth selling, man. So yeah, man, let's just get in some clips of us hosting and show y'all how the show went from the beginning to the end.
Let me formally introduce myself. For all you that don't know who I am, my name is Jaheen Gilkey, aka Young Gilk, aka Guilt the Foo Foo, aka Kid Gilkey, aka Guilt to Gilk Girl. I'm here with my lovely co-host.
Well, I don't have that many names, but you can find me around campus as Brianna, but I go by B Polly, so make sure y'all follow us on Instagram, Snapchat, or whatever. And make sure y'all use the Snapchat filter and tell people to get here and support it, y'all. There's a lot of people out here. Stand up, let the people see. This is a lovely lady.
Come on, baby.
Oh, yeah, she's working.
Baby, she's a natural queen.
Yes.
Let me know who you are, where you from.
Georgia. I'm from Georgia. What's Georgia?
Hey, ATL, stand up. I'm from Atlanta. ATL, where y'all at?
No.
ATL, where y'all at?
No.
Stand up.
Stand up.
Stand up. Stand up.
Are you fine?
Hey.
Are you fine?
Hey.
Are you fine?
Hey.
Are you fine?
Hey.
Are you fine? Y'all come shop at Jazzy Girl Boutique. Y'all had it right next to Nelson. Time. Happy hour, 2 for $25. Come back.
You have a drink in the building?
I know you do. I bet you choose Phyllis. But anyway, if you're a beautiful black queen, I want you to say yes.
Yes!
Say yes.
Yeah. I was wearing New Balance. Yeah. Pull the horses on me. Oh, she trying to ride on me. Oh, baby girl, I'm a beast. Yeah, I'm your beast, I'm the least. Yeah. Like pit bulls running on the street. I might bite you, might bite you too. Cause a girl, ooh, I might fuck up and then I catch it back. I'm a big dog, I catch the slack. If the booty big, I'ma kill her back. If she's skinny too, I'ma kill her back. If she's big too, she kill come around.
I miss all my trips and falling.
Yeah.
I don't know what I'm saying.
Yeah.
When these mothers come out, they clean. Y'all need to turn up.
Hello.
Yeah.
Y'all give it up for Free Party, man. Yeah.
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 That was the fashion show, Pink Poison. I mean, we showed up, showed out, did what we had to do. And I ain't gonna lie, Bree Polly, you was alright, you know what I'm saying?
First of all, like, y'all, that was my first time ever in my life hosting anything.
I wasn't even talking about hosting. She was good to me. I was talking about her attire, you know what I'm saying? If I was drunk, maybe I might be like, Bree look good, you know what I'm saying? But she was like,
I can't never get a straight compliment, guys. Okay, he gonna post a picture of me. Tell me what y'all think. Let me know, honestly.
We're going to post a picture of Bree real fast and let y'all see what she was working with. Y'all tell me. You know what I'm saying?
But one girl had a whole skirt that lit up.
Ooh, but that thing was fire. I'm talking about, at first I didn't even notice, bro. A girl came out with the little, Bree was like, look at her. I was like, okay, yeah, she cute. But then when she came back, I seen her dress like flashing, bro. Blew my mind.
Talk about working. So shout out to Jalen, girl, because yeah. When I tell you she had to walk on. I saw a little draws, you know, some slob, a little good mouth.
Hey,
you know
all players be slipping sometimes, you know what I'm saying? She was looking real delectable, you know what I'm saying? But anyway, look, we're going to go on to the next event, man. You know, on the yard at Grambling, it get turnt, you know what I'm saying? We got a little thing called Turnt Up Tuesdays on the yard.
We get turnt.
Yeah, from the hours of like 11 to 1, you know what I'm saying? But ain't nobody really got class during that time. And people out here turnt up, you know what I'm saying? But we don't only just do it in the daytime, Bree. Between lunch hours.
Look, let me tell you, when the calf is open, ain't nobody turn everybody eating the calf, you know what I'm saying? But as soon as it be closed at 8 o'clock,
hey.
Oh.
Where we at?
The yard.
The yard, man.
With the DJ.
Yeah, man, look. So we gonna show y'all how we be turned up on the yard day and night. You feel me? Bam!
If we were made in his image, then call us by our names. Most intellects do not believe in God, but they fear us just the same. Oh, on and on and on and on. My cipher keeps moving like a rolling stone. On and on and on and on. All night till the break of dawn.
Shit.
fuck you thought.
Man, look, the best thing you can ever do is work for yourself. If you're not employed by yourself, then that means that you're making someone else rich. And that's never a good thing or whatnot. We as a people, we have to do better for ourselves. We have to be able to create opportunities for the people around us. I always remember, you're only the man that you are, that you help someone else be.
Bars, nigga.
This is what I do. I sit back, relax, and watch the game with my crew. I could pop cans, but I don't pop brew. I'd rather pop the girl trying to get this money too. She looking at me, ooh, she might think her thoughts a few. I'm that dude who they talk about, I'm really kinda rude. But I'm nice on the slick, if she say she trying to kick, we could do that. I ain't talking soccer, take it to Red Lobster. I'm a dog, straight shot up, got money in my pocket. You balling with that boy, she could catch my bottle rocket. Yeah. I'm really about it. From the down south, 985, they really diving. I came up from growing up, blocking and fighting. I used to joke 6 months, GED, I indicted. Fuck with me, I ain't mean a curse, but this is how it be. I made a college with a GED, right here on my feet. Yeah, 3 stripes, like the things up on my feet. I had to take my loss and get it back, but that's just how it be. Grew up on the streets, no, I'm not called that black, but I smoked that broccoli, I might probably have that pack, yeah.
I'm coming back in a helicopter. And I'ma land that bitch on top of the cab.
Fuck that shit.
Real top.
Yeah. But all right, anyway. Oh hey.
Sorry, we just.
Yeah, we was somewhere else with it. But look, man, the last event, what we just showed them, the turn up on the yard.
Yeah.
All right, cool.
But it gotta get a little serious. You know what I'm saying? We are some intellectuals. We are in college.
We are in college. We're intellectuals, and we are black. And we care about that, you know what I'm saying? So one of the events that happened the other day was the Rise Up event. Name of the event, I'm sorry, before cut you off, babe. Go ahead, tell them the title of the event, go ahead.
Well, title was, Why Do Black Men Hate Black Women?
Yeah, man, we had some good dialogue in there, you know what I'm saying? And just by the title, I know y'all know that it got heated in that thing, but it was all love at the end of the day, and I encourage all black people, all HBCUs to meet like that, you know what I'm saying? Meet every day, you know what I'm saying? And just talk about what it is to be black, the problems we have, and iron it out, man. Practice makes perfect, you feel me?
And when you talking, make sure you're not talking over each other, you know what I'm saying? Listen, you might disagree, you know what I'm saying? I may not agree with what he agree with, but at the same time, we both can be right. It's just ways that we gotta learn how to solve it, you know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
And that's the only way if we stick together, we can actually do something and change the world.
Ain't nothing wrong with debating in a healthy way, you know what I'm saying? As long as it's for building and moving forward, man, the sky's the limit, man. So I encourage all my black people to do that, man. We the generation, man. Let's step up, man. I'm going to hold y'all to that.
They always asking us why.
Yeah, man. So let's get some of these Rise Up clips while we sit here lecturing y'all. Let's just see what it was like, man. Go ahead and take them to.
Shit,
States, you know what I'm saying? Ferron Rush represents Chicago, you know, rise up. We really finna get to the bottom of the problems that's going on with black people. So it's the first step. It's the first step. We gotta unite. We gotta come together. So that being said,
Gramlife Night Invades. About to knock out this story. Rise up.
We love black women. Black women, we love you. Say no to the white woman, man. Hey, white women are the devil.
White women are not the devil. We here. I like the white women in Louisiana. Take no disrespect to y'all. Y'all always got the Chick-fil-A with the sauce.
What's up? It's going down right here. State, hold up, scratch that. The Gramlife State University. Like everybody and somebody with a registered fish. We here with Rise Up. I love it.
Why not Gramlife?
Today's event is Why Black Men Hate Black Women. Pretty much, it's just an open discussion. The part one was more of an event than this one, but.
I think it's ignorance, and I think it comes from environmental influence.
They say that we always saying this about black men or whatever. It's like what we saying that because of what they're putting out.
You have the simple movement. Everybody's heard it. My mama even said it to me. Niggas ain't shit.
Yeah, that's, you didn't even have to ask black men when they're belittled.
Women do it themselves. I mean, I say at least once a week. I'm gonna be straight up. Like, you
know. Like, and it's unfortunate that I didn't say it myself, but it's real.
They so quick to scorn a black man, but when they get around Tom and Ben, they pull up. And pull up means like they bow down.
They become that submissive role that they're supposed to be in. Yeah.
A nigga gonna do whatever you let him do. Okay. You feel me? If he's your nigga.
Hello.
You let him think shit is okay?
He gonna think shit is okay.
If you tell him, yo, this shit is not okay,
maybe he'll know that certain shit is not okay. Niggas ain't shit
because y'all let them not be shit.
Wow, okay.
One more time.
I love black women. Wait, as far as the term, like, niggas ain't shit, it don't take a certain race for you to not be shit. If you're not shit, you're not shit.
What's the point of bashing people all the time? Like, I feel like people need to just, like,
stop all the self-hate, the hate period, and just come to their senses and see what the real issue is.
Whenever you see a black man bashing black women on social media, what do you do?
So I definitely speak out, and I feel that any man should speak out. I know that that's their opinion, and you feel like you talk to a brick wall, but still, take the time to educate somebody because you never know. It could change their perspective, and it could help another black sister out because she's feeling bad about herself.
That has nothing to do with me. I'm my own man. If he feel like that's what he want, if he feel like he don't like her cause she too dark for him, then that's on him. That has nothing to do with me. Do I like it? No. But at the same time, I'm gonna do me. He gonna do him, keep him moving.
Basically, I just feel like, as far as social media, it's built so that you don't have to encounter them. If somebody comes up to you and says that shit, That's really not cool.
Because they're talking to you. But if they're doing it how many miles away over the web, they're doing that shit because they know it's wrong.
They know they probably can't get touched, and the most you could do is say some shit that they're gonna ignore or block or whatever.
There are people in this world called trolls, bro. They called trolls.
And like, if you really like, you even from YouTube to Instagram to Twitter,
all this. Like, it's one. Like, all you have to do is just search this person's username. Like, they might be registered trolls. Like, this is what they do. As soon as you reply back and say something, they won. You can drop facts. Martin Luther King did this. We built this. Did that. Man, they don't care. You reacted.
The only way to beat that is by beating them outside of social media, which doesn't even fucking matter.
In this real world, getting this money, doing buying land, buying business, like
not social media. That's a facade. That's just there.
People use that for promotion.
Things like this, because we go to a HBCU, these should be things that are, we should be rising up. We should always have to do this, you know? And it shouldn't be a problem either. It shouldn't be something that we get mad at and smack it, you know, taste ourselves, you know, all that too. You know, it should be something that we want to do because we're standing up for each other.
I'm gonna get to my
solution by taking a different route. How can we get this to get across campus or even across the world? Lead by example. Mahatma Gandhi led by example.
What's happening, man? We just had a great Rise Up meeting, you know what I'm saying? It was great, it was powerful. I encourage more of my people to come to these meetings. It's just one of the few meetings that we have on campus, you know what I'm saying? I encourage everybody to like spread the word about us uplifting each other as black people, man. You feel?
I want people to know to drop more knowledge, more intellect than hate, you know what I'm saying? Because the more intellect we do, you know, and even our opinions may be different, but at the end of the day, remember who you are, remember why you're here. And remember, we can't change, so.
We all a team, man.
One human race, one love, but we gotta start with us and then spread the word.
You feel me? Let me play, man. Let's get to the championship. You feel me? It's all fun and games, man, but sometimes we gotta come together and be real about this. You feel me?
Real talk.
Now here's a little entertainment for your soul.
L-Y-R-I-C-A-L-Q-U-E-S-T L-Y-R-I-C-A-L The Quest for Lyrical Quest. Oh, oh, oh.
Yeah. Man, nah, Dana Goofy had to bring her own little cup and then go fill it. Thought she wasn't caught. She was caught. That lady said, excuse me, ma'am. Excuse me.
We had just got through running stadiums, four stadiums in the express. I was dead as fuck.
And that's just, like, bro, that shit was so funny. The lady came, tapped on the shoulder, was like, excuse me, ma'am. Dana was like, man, get off me.
I had just left track practice, you know what I'm saying? I was thirsty, like, I needed that.
She was thirsty, hell.
I needed that.
That girl's finna die for that cup,
no,
boy.
Bruh,
if y'all die for y'all rights, our shit's gonna die for that cup, bruh. We'll be successful as black people. You feel?
She had to walk away. She had to walk away.
Let me drop this knowledge instead of dick, ladies.
Look, when life gives you lemons, everybody gonna tell you make lemonade. Alright? Fuck that shit. If life gives you lemons, you make you a cup of lemonade for damn show while you out there counting them damn seeds. You plant them, make you some damn money, sell them lemons.
Sell them lemons.
Make your lemonade and make you some more seeds, and guess what? You got lemons all over the damn place.
And bowling on the block with the motherfucking black 3Bs. Bowling on the block with the black. You feel me?
You feel me?
Yeah. Shout yourself out, man. Talk to the people who
talk
you
to
is.
I don't want to talk to the people.
All right. Anonymous.
Yeah, anonymous. Yes. Anonymous. That's how you got to be. They know my face, so when they see me.
That's her.
What happened with it?
What's good, Graham? What's up? What's up? I'm from Cali. You already know. LA rapping. It's your boy D Welch.
Yeah.
What's good?
Yeah. Episode 1 and 2. Hey, West Love was holding me down as the cameraman. Hey.
Yes, sir.
West Love.
Y'all know how it goes.
West Love was there in the beginning.
I'm on the spot. On the spot. You know.
Yeah.
I got it for you, bro.
My boy West
All
Love.
Day, every day, man. What's up with
you? Yeah. Shout yourself out, Wes. What you do, Wes? What else you do, man? You got your little camera thing,
you
know, too.
Hey, yeah, you know, I got my own little photography business, too, man. I just hit up at westloveimages.com, you know what I'm saying? Hit me up on my email at westlove4 @gmail.com or whatever, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, we can get those shots. Because, you know, I only want nines and dimes over here, you know what I'm saying? That's all we shooting with.
What's your slogan, Wes? What's your slogan?
Man, you tell them. Hey, what's my slogan, bro? What's my slogan?
They want to hear it from you, Wes. Yes, sir.
Oh, man. Hey, yes, sir.
Yes,
you already
sir.
Know how this go,
bro.
Yes, sir.
I was trying to, like, get around your cameras.
Hey. Uh-oh. Part 2 singing.
Oh, my gosh.
Let's go.
The owns of my own.
Something about the
rain.
Hair
blowing. Yeah, give us something about the rain.
Last night it just kept raining and raining and raining and raining and raining. I called your phone, it kept ringing and ringing and ringing and ringing and ringing. Where were you last night? Because you were not by my side. Why you gotta keep playing and playing and playing and playing and playing? You never do what you be saying and saying and saying and saying and saying. And it's raining again. So I guess I'll make amends. Stop, y'all.
Hey.
Yeah. I really hate this.
What your name is?
What up,
girl?
What
your
name is?
Oh, they call you Queen.
Bro, you're not ready.
Hey, girl, who your name is?
This is our, okay, you guys. If you don't know, me and JoJo.
You gotta get the beginning when they start.
Okay. Me and JoJo were high school chilling coaches. We didn't make this up. Our girls did this themselves.
They are very rich, and I just don't want to stunt their creativity.
Yeah. Shout out to Gramlife.
We on Gramlife. Sean J rolled up. Get Sean J on there.
Yeah, all star.
Squad.
I
don't know. I'm supposed to be braiding Stacia hair.
Oh, what's that?
And then I'm gonna be ready to be drunk. Don't get that part
what's
of
the
I'm a Christian, sweet lady. I love Jesus.
What we drinking on tonight?
You know, it's whatever.
Anything. We getting on that Henny?
Anything is possible. Is that what the people say?
So should I go get a bottle now or later?
Wait, listen. Don't say that I told you not to study.
No, I ain't.
Okay.
If you want it, I'm so depressed. You ain't gotta say too much. When I look in your eyes, I can tell you wanna fuck. And you ain't gotta call me your boo. Just as bad as you wanna fuck, I wanna fuck too.
No, 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 you ain't gotta say too much. When I look in your eyes, I can tell you
wanna fuck. Oh, what you looking at?
Remember to always stay ahead of the game.
Get gilky, hoe.